Good morning, students. In the last class, we discussed about grading. What is grading? Grading means grouping the outlets into groups such that to increase grade of service with the less number of trunks. So the main objective of using grading is to increase the grade of service with the less number of trunks that we studied in the previous class. There we studied how to divide it into groups. The formula G is equal to where n is the number of trunks and k is the number of available paths, availability. From this we obtain the number of groups. Generally this number of groups is an even number. So if you take a nearest integer, you have to take nearest even integer, you have to take while finding the number of groups. And we have seen some examples of grading, or some methods of grading. One is progressive grading. Skipped grading and homogeneous grading. So I have mainly focused on this progressive grading. Okay, so what I discussed, we have taken an example of finding the optimum value of traffic intensity. So we have drawn some diagram like this, graded diagrams we have drawn. So these dashes represents the trunk lines. So this is example for graded circuit with four groups, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and the availability is 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Can take it as some 10. 10 is the availability factor. Okay, so after the grouping, we have seen like this, something like we have taken some initials and half commons and full commons. So we call them as singles or individuals. And these are called as half commons or doubles. Half commons or partial commons or doubles. And this is called as full common or quadruples. So since we are moving from singles to the quadruple, it is called as progressive grading. There we have to find out the optimum values of singles, doubles and quadruples that we have seen. We are finding the values of given rate, D1 we have to find out, D2 we have to find out, and D3 we have to find out. Okay, that is, what is D1? D1 stands for successive difference of your singles and doubles plus successive difference between the doubles and quadruples. So which is having the least value, that is going to be the best solution for your grading that we have seen in the previous classes. Okay, now in this class we will discuss about link system. What is a link system and what is the advantage of using link system? So to discuss this, first of all you should know what is a transit exchange. What is a transit exchange? It contains some incoming trunks and it contains some outgoing trunks. The number of incoming trunks may not be equal to number of outgoing trunks. In this example I am taking, it is having some n number of incoming trunks and n outgoing trunks. May or may not equal. In this case I am taking them as equal. So what is this one? This is nothing but, it may be a cross point exchange. It may be a cross point exchange or it may be a Strouser exchange. Anything it may have. Okay, so based upon the type of switching system you use, okay, you can say whether it is a blocking exchange or non-blocking exchange. So generally, if you take a square matrix of crossbar array, so here we have 4 inlets and 4 outlets. This is crossbar full. So here we use some switches, right? We use some switches as cross points. This is one switch, this is a switch. This is cross point. Okay, so whenever the switch is closed, it is going to establish connection between this inlet to this outlet. Okay, if it is A and it is B means, it is going to establish connection between A inlet and B outlet. So in case of a full matrix or square matrix crossbar array, we have to use one switch for one inlet outlet pair. For example, if I want to connect between A to the B, I have to use AB cross point. If I am going to connect B to A, then I have to use BA cross point. That is what we studied in the first unit about square matrix of a crossbar switch. So if I am using a circuit like this with one single stage, if I am connecting n inlets to n outlets with the one single stage of your cross point, the drawback here is, so if you want to move, if you want to establish a connection between A to the B, then it has to use AB switch only. Only one path is available. Okay, it cannot use remaining cross points to establish connection to the A to the B. For example, if this is failed, switch is failed means temporarily we are unable to provide connection between A to the B because there are no other alternative paths between A to the B. So the drawback in using a single stage is, this is nothing but your single stage. Single stage switch. So in case of single stage switch, the drawback is there are no alternating paths between one inlet outlet pair. For example, if this outlet is busy with some other subscriber, you cannot route it. Hence it faces blocking. And hence it faces blocking. So to avoid such cases, that is for providing multiple number of alternate paths, we have to go for stages. So what is link system now? Link system is going to interconnect multiple stages. That is called your link system. Clear? What is link system? With the help of link system, link system is, we are going to interconnect multiple stages. That means outlet of one stage is connected to the inlet of another stage. So in such a scenario, we can able to provide more number of alternating paths from one inlet to outlet and another outlet page. So that even if any path is failed or switch is failed, it is going to choose another path to establish connection between inlet outlet trunk, or can call as inlet outlet trunk, incoming trunk to the outgoing trunk. So this is one example here we've seen. So here totally this is a stage. So this is a two stage network, so which contains some 63 inlets and connected to some 15 outlets. 63 inlets and 15 outlets in the form of a modular design. This is called as a modular design. We studied already about modular design. Modular design means what? So we are going to divide the number of inlets and outlets into small modules. Okay. So this is one example. Here you can see, the thing here is, every outlet in stage 1 should be connected to the inlet of the succeeding stage. So 1 to this 1. Here 2 inlets to the first stage. 2 inlets to the second stage. 2 inlets to the third stage. And 2 with the fourth stage. So to reach a particular outlet, I can use different paths. Generally, in case of there is not much more difference between a two stage and single stage. So single stage and two stage are not having much difference. The only difference is with respect to the alternate paths. In case of single stage, no alternate paths are available. But in case of two stage switch, network will have some alternate path. But the number of cross points, everything are same. Okay. Now we see an example of two stage network. So this is an example of a two stage switching system. So here n incoming trunks are there and n outgoing trunks are there. So I cannot use a single switch. I cannot use a single switch with the n inlets and n outlets. I cannot use. Here I am using a modular design. That is, I am going to divide the number of inlets into small. Each module contains some small n. So totally how many stages are there like this? For example, I am having 16 inlets as capital N. I am assuming that the small n is 4. So if I am having 4 inlets for each module, means totally it contains n by n. That is equal to 16 by 4. That is equal to totally it contains 4 modules. Okay, n by n is going to give the number of modules in a given stage. So in this case, it should have an n by n modules to implement the n inlets. Since the inlets and outlets are same, at outlet also we can have n by n modules. So how to interconnect them? So to interconnect them, the idea here is every outlet in stage 1 should connect it to the every inlet in the next stage. That means first outlet is connected to the first module, one inlet. Similarly, second inlet is connected to the second stage, second module. And nth, this is how much? And nth inlet is, outlet is connected to the nth module. We have to connect like this. Similarly, the first inlet outlet of next stage is connected to the first module of second stage. Second outlet to the second module of second stage. And nth outlet to the nth module of second stage. So if you connect like this, then you can able to provide more number of alternate paths for a given inlet to the outlet pair. Okay? So for these cases, our objective is to find out what is the number of modules in each stage, that is first point. And second point is, we have to find out the total number of links. First one is module number, how many modules can have to construct such a modular designs. Second one is, how many links are required. Links means these are the links. The wires which are used to interconnect the two stages are called as links. Okay, what are links? Links means the number of wires or trunks required to interconnect two stages is called as links. And third one is total cost of the cross points. And fourth point is, what is the value of M or N? What is the value of N for which it is having minimum cost? So these four points we have to analyze for each and every stages. For two stage switch, for three stage and for four stage. Now in this class, we will discuss about how to find out these values for N two stage switch. And one more point here to be noted is, so how to establish a connection between a chosen inlet and a required outlet in case of multi-stage switching. So there are two methods are there. One is called as a step-by-step connection, and another one is called as with the help of conditional connection. So what is the meaning of step by step connection? In the step by step connection, if you take some stages, stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, stage 4, some and so on. In case of step by step, here first it is going to choose one of the outlet is control, another inlet of the second stage. Next it is going to verify for the free outlets in the stage 2. And it is going to connect to the one of the free inlet to the third stage. And finally it is going to connect one of the free inlet of last stage. And finally it is going to choose the appropriate outlet that is free. So in this case, it is going to establish connection from an inlet to a outlet in a step-by-step manner. Hence the name step-by-step control method. Step-by-step control method. So in this method, what is the drawback is, once it is moving, if in the final stage of selection, if this outlet is free, busy, then what happens? Unnecessarily, it is establishing connection and finally it is unable to reach the destination. Therefore, the call is terminated. Clear? So, in this case of step-by-step switching, if the outlets are busy at the time is, then the call may be lost. So, but in case of condition control, here we use a mechanism called markers. We use a marker. A marker means a controller. Okay, here this marker is having provision to control both input side and output side. So that it is going to establish some link to verify the connectivity. If the connectivity is okay, then only it is going to establish connection between A to the B or a required inlet to the required outlet. If that link is not available means, then it is going to choose for another path. Therefore, in case of conditional control method, unnecessarily it will not waste the calls. It will not terminate the calls, because it is going to understand that because it is having control over input and output side, it is going to create some path and it is going to verify for connectivity. If connectivity is present, then only it is going to establish a connection between inlet to the outlets. This is the mechanism they are going to use in case of linked systems to establish connection between an inlet to the outlets, required outlets. Okay, so this is one example of choosing a two-stage switch switching system. Okay, so in this case, what is G here? G is equal to nothing but number of modules, that is equal to n by n. Okay, now we will discuss these points, that is the four points one by one. So here, the total number of primary switches is equal to how much? Primary switches is equal to n by n. So how many modules? Nothing but number of modules actually. Number of modules. So it is also called as primary switches. Similarly, the secondary switch count is also same, because it is having n incoming trunks and n outgoing trunks. The primary switches count is equal to secondary switches count. So this value may differ when we use different topologies. That means if it is having m inlets and n outlets, in that case the number of primary switches and secondary switches may vary. But in this case of square array, both are same. So G is equal to n by n. Okay. So the total number of cross points in this case is how much? So input side Gn and output side Gn. So totally it is equal to 2Gn. This many number of cross points are required in the entire two stage switch. And number of links is equal to G square. See, right? So here G outlets are there and G inlets are there. Okay, so how many links are required means G into G is going to give the number of links required to interconnect these two stages. Okay, therefore the number of links required is equal to g square, that is equal to n by n whole square, and thus the number of cross points, you see here what is the value of here, what is g here, 2 into n into g, nothing but n by n, that is equal to 2 n square by n, right? This is the cost of your cross points. Coming to the links, g square is equal to n by n whole square. If you have clearly see here, cost is proportional to 1 by n, small n, whereas number of links is proportional to 1 by n square. So as an engineer, our objective is to reduce the number of cross points. So how to reduce the number of cross points means, by increasing the n value, we can reduce the cost, because it is in denominator. As n increases, c will reduces. So in this case, what is the drawback means? Drawback, not condition, is as the n increases, the number of links required, the number of links required to connect the interstages will reduces. So therefore, what happens as the number of links increases? Because it is going to affect your traffic handling capability. Okay, so to avoid such cases, we have to use some optimum value of number of links as n. You can take it as optimum value as n for better traffic handling capability. Okay, now we can substitute these values here. In place of g square, then put n here. What happens? So in place of g square, put n. What will get? So n is equal to n by n whole square. So 1 is equal to 1 by n square. Therefore n is equal to root n. So for providing better performance, you have to choose the number of inlets per switch is root n. That is called square root of n, you can take. So with this value of n, what is C2 value now? C2 is equal to how much? C2 is equal to 2 n square by n. That is equal to how much? 2 into n is square root of n. So n square by root n, that is equal to 2 into n power 2 plus 1 by 2 is 3 by 2. So this is the cost of system if I am using the optimum is as n. Now, so in this case, so far we are taking it as square. Number of inlets is equal to number of outlets. Is equal to number of outlets. Now, there are some cases where the number of inlets may be less than number of outlets, or number of inlets may be greater than number of outlets. Now we will take one case where the number of inlets is greater than number of outlets. Here I am taking the value as m. M is the number of inlets and n is the number of outlets. So such type of circuits are called as concentrator circuits. Concentrator means inlets are more, outlets are less. We can also have this case also, m less than n. That means this comes under expansion circuit. Expansion. And this is concentration, concentrator switches and expansion switches. Okay, now we'll discuss how to find the minimum cost for getting this concentrator switch. So the number of primary switches is how much now? In the previous case it is what? It is n by n. Now I'm taking it as m by n. That means each module is having m inlets, small m inlets. Capital M is the total number of inlets in the primary or first stage, and capital N is the number of outlets in the second stage. What is small m here? Small m means number of inlets per module. You have seen, right? This is one module, this is second module, this is third module, this is fourth module. You have seen, right? This is contains 4 4 4 4 4. In this case, what is m? capital M is 16 and small m is 4. Got the point? So here the number of primary stitches is equal to capital M by small m. Similarly, the number of secondary stitches is equal to capital N by small m. So number of cross points per primary stitch, how much? It is m into n by n. Okay, the number of cross points per primary switch. So for one switch, how many cross points are there? So this one primary switch contains m inlets. What about the number of outlets? It contains n by n outlets. Therefore, the total number of cross points is equal to m into n by n. Similarly, the number of cross points per second switch is how much? For outlet side, second stage, what are the number of outlets? Number of outlets is equal to, per switch is n. What about inlet? It is m by m. Therefore, number of cross points is equal to m by m into n. Okay. Therefore, what is total number of cross points means? Add these two. It is going to give the total number of cross points in the entire stage. Now, here the total number of links is equal to number of primary switches into number of secondary switches. Okay, you see right here? In this case, the number of secondary switches into number of primary switches is going to give the total number of links. Therefore, use the formula here to find out the total number of links. That is equal to mn by m by m into n by n is going to give the total number of links. So for optimal traffic, let us assume that this number of links is equal to n. Okay, for optimal number of, to get the optimal traffic, you have to choose the number of links as n. So from this assumption, I can write here as m by m is into 1 by n is equal to 1. That implies n is equal to m by m. You can use this assumption here. And okay, sorry, n is equal to this one. From this you can write n as m by m. Right, n is equal to m by m. Okay, therefore, now find the value of C2. What is C2 we can have? So in this expression, substitute that value. What is value here we can have? So here, in place of n, put m by m. Correct? This is what? So n is equal to, sorry, this is wrong. This is capital M by small m. N is equal to capital M by small m. Now substitute that value here. What will get? C2 is equal to, this is m n by mn, sorry, m small n plus n m by nm. So nm get cancelled and mm get cancelled. So if I take common mn, I am going to get 1 by n plus 1 by m. Okay, in place of n, I can put m by n. So C2 is equal to mn into 1 by capital M by small m plus 1 by small m. That is equal to how much? Mn into m get taken numerator, this is m by small m, right? So we get small m by capital M plus 1 by m. This is the total cost if I am using optimal number of links. Okay, now for what value of m to see this minimum, that I have to calculate. Okay, so our object is to calculate for what value of M will get a least number of cross points. So how to do it? Generally we know the process of finding minimum value or maximum value. What is the procedure? C2 is equal to Mn into 1 by n plus 1 by m is the cost, that is equal to Mn into n means 1 by capital M by small m plus 1 by small m, that is equal to Mn into m by m plus 1 by m. How to get the minimum value means differentiate C2 with respect to m and equate to 0. Okay, this value and find the value of m. This value of m is going to give the minimum cost. Okay, so differentiate is what we get. So mn is a constant, only m have to vary. So this is dc2 by dm is equal to mn into, this is 1 by m, this is how much? Minus 1 by m square. Okay, so for this, n equal to 0, 0 is equal to mn into 1 by m plus minus 1 by m square. So 1 by m is equal to 1 by m square. Therefore m square is equal to capital M and m is equal to root m. So if m is equal to root m, then it is going to give an optimum cost, that is low cost, minimum cost of the switching system. Okay, so this is the value. Now we have a problem that we have to design a two-stage switch network for connecting 200 incoming trunks to 200 outgoing trunks. So what is the value of n you can take? N is equal to root n, that are be there, right? Number of modules is equal to root n. Similar in previous case, m is equal to root m. I can take it as n is equal to root n. Anything is same. So what is root n value of this one? Root 100 is how much? Something approximately. Root 200. Okay, so here the number designing the number of modules, there are some standard values are there. You cannot choose as such value. So since it is 14.14, I can take either a 10 cross n or a 10 cross 20 or 20 cross 10. So there are some three combinations are there to obtain the same capability, 200 incoming trunks and 200 outgoing trunks with the help of this many modules. 10 modules are 20 modules of 10, 10 modules, 20 modules of 10 cross 10 or 10 modules of 10 cross 20. So you can see some diagram here for different values. So in switch A, here how many are there? 20. 10 cross 10, that means 10 inlets for each module. So 10 into 20 is going to give 200. How many are there? 20 modules are there. Here we are speaking the word switches and modules, both are same. Switches and modules, both are same. Clear? Or everything is same. Okay, in unit 1 is we are using the terminology modules. In unit number 5, here is the technology switches, so don't get confused, both are same. So how many modules are there? 20 modules are there and each module contains 10 switches, therefore the total number of incoming trunks is equal to 200. Similarly at outlet side we want 200. So how many switches I can go for? I can use 10 switches or 10 modules each of 20 cross 20, therefore it is going to give 200 outlet. This is the first configuration. And second one is reverse of this. Okay, so there are different combinations are there for providing the same incoming trunks and outgoing trunks, but the cost may vary based upon the top watch we prefer, and the number of links also get varies. So so next class we'll discuss about a three-stage switch, and for that also we have to find out what is the total number of links required, what's the total cost of the switching system, cost points, and what is the optimal value of cost of the cross points. That we'll discuss. Thank you.